And welcome back. Well, every week we look forward to hearing from a volunteer with the Farm Women's Organization, Common Ground.
Right now we are getting a recipe from this week's volunteer, Ruth Reedy. Here's how to make a tasty oatmeal raisin quick bread.
Well, here in Pure Nebraska, we always love to get a good recipe and one that is popular, and sometimes you can actually tell if a recipe is popular just by maybe how much food is on the book or on the index card. Joining me now with more on this is Ruth Reedy. Ruth, good to see you again.
Good to see you too, John. Yeah, this recipe has been one of my family's favorites for a very long time. I don't have the original magazine article that my mom clipped it with, but she had it. I copied the recipe from her, and the recipe card shows that I've cooked this a lot of times. And so it's an oatmeal raisin quick bread. And so what we've got with this is we've got a cup and a half of flour that I already have in my bowl. And we're going to add half a cup of sugar and a cup of oatmeal. It doesn't matter if it's quick oatmeal or old-fashioned, whatever you want to use. And then I've also got in here, I've got a half a teaspoon of soda, half a teaspoon of salt, and 2 teaspoons of baking powder. So that's going to go in there. So those are all my dry ingredients. And then I've got my liquid ingredients. The recipe online is going to say that it's the juice of an orange plus enough water to make 1 cup. And so you can do that, or you can just have prepared orange juice. And then I've got 1 egg that's kind of slightly beaten. And then I've got a cup of raisins. Now, some people are not raisin lovers. I happen to be. I think that raisins are one of the best things ever. But you could substitute chopped apples, or you could even just leave them out if you don't like them, or some other sort of fruit. And being a quick bread, you don't want to overstir because that makes your loaf of bread be a funny shape. I forgot one ingredient, John. I need to have 2 tablespoons of melted butter. But we're going to just add that and stir it in. And then we're going to bake this for an hour, about an hour, at 325, which a lot of things get baked at 350. This one's at 325 because you have to really get through all of this. This is kind of a heavy bread, and so we don't want to get it too hot and burn it before we get it all the way done. Okay. And then I've got the finished product right over here. The best way to eat this is warm, with a nice coating of absolutely soft, real butter.
Thank you, Ruth. We appreciate that recipe. Thanks for being here today.